Hi guys, and welcome back to another F1 2020 My Team episode. This is part 18 and we're going to be doing some racing today at Zandvoort. I think that's how you say it. At the Zandvoort circuit in the Dutch Grand Prix. So we had quite a decent qualifying, so hopefully we can get a top 10 finish in the race and get some more points. 36 laps, guys. Apparently the weather's going to be fine, so let's get going.
It was 35 years ago that the late great Niki Lauda took his 25th and final Grand Prix win here at Zandvoort. He came from 10th on the grid to beat his McLaren teammate Alain Prost by just 0.2 of a second. Well, Zandvoort is a very different circuit today, of course, but still one with an incredible legacy. And we're going to add to that one to try and overtake. Now, Anthony Davidson, I wonder, might we be in for some early pit stops today for the midfield teams? To put some pressure on or disrupting things for the leaders up front?
If you're in the middle of the pack, you know, you've got your own race to run. I don't think they're going to be thinking about causing trouble up front. However, closer to the head of the pack, don't be surprised to see some split strategies. If you're running second and third, for example, bringing one car in for an undercut while leaving the other one out there longer can put a lot of pressure on the leader and maybe force them into an error.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Vettel, Lewis Hamilton, and Albon. Lucky, Stroll, Perez, and Daniel Ricciardo. Kvyat, Sainz, Lando Norris, and Raikkonen. Giovinazzi, Russell, Romain Grosjean, and Dorian Boccalacci. Magnussen, Gasly, Latifi, and Esteban Ocon rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Okay folks, I'm going to be running a one-stop strategy. Going to be pitting around lap 11. Just run over my car setup. I'm going 6.9 on the aero. Transmission, I'm going 50% and 58%. There's a suspension geometry. Suspension, I'm going 1, 3, 6, 7, 2, 4. Brakes 95% and 52%. And there's the tyre pressures. Okay, we're up to fourth, guys.
That's a decent start. Good job.
Thank you.
So he goes past, but you would expect that with him having the faster car.
Will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Energy store is getting worn, reducing our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. Fuel is looking really good, you're managing it well. Gap ahead is 2.3 seconds.
Vettel's gone.
The car ahead is a second a lap faster than you. Flag. Okay, clear. Verstappen has the lead.
Okay guys, I'm really, really comfortable here. So we're way ahead of Dorian.
Use your overtake button more. It's time to utilize some of this energy.
Lap 9 guys, pitting on a lap 11.
Verstappen's in first place. To the car ahead is 3.1 seconds. box. We're coming in this lap. The car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. Fuel target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available.
Okay, guys, we're in the pits. How far we drop back. Shouldn't drop back too much, to be honest.
Exit now. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Engine is showing small signs of wear. Power output will be down.
See if we can catch this guy.
The car in front is 1.8 seconds.
Okay, so he's in the pits. The engine sounds terrible.
Some time to the car behind. Okay, gap ahead is 10.7 seconds.
Okay, lap 17 guys, now in P5.
Just fitted the hard tyres, car ahead now on the hard compound.
So Oakley 6 and 7 can have a bit of a tussle while I pull away.
lap to the car in front is 12.9 seconds. Behind is 39.5 seconds. Let's use overtake and burn some of this energy.
So that's my fastest lap.
Front is 24.7 seconds.
Lap 22, guys.
Thank you.
still in P5. Lap
23 seconds.
Lap 24. Still in P5. Barring an incident, guys, I think we've got P5 locked down now.
To the car in front is 13.5 seconds. Verstappen's out in front. The car ahead is 15.8 seconds.
So they're really pulling away from us.
Is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap.
Well, since this last less than 10 laps left, we should be okay.
No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them.
Lap 29. Okay, Albon's catching us.
Gap to car in front is 19.8 seconds.
The tyres are feeling a bit sticky.
Behind is 5.3 seconds.
Okay, with five laps to go, guys, I don't think he's going to catch us.
Okay, gap ahead is 22.2 seconds.
Got to stay on this overtake button when we can.
Monitoring somewhere on the ICE, be aware that we will start to see a loss of power.
Okay, lap 33. Three laps to go.
Full course caution. The safety car is out. Keep an eye on the delta. We need to keep it positive to avoid a penalty.
Oh, great.
Slow down. Maintain positive delta.
This is all we need. Okay, I could do with this safety car staying out because this potentially has wrecked my entire race.
Again, the safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car in this lap. There's four laps of fuel remaining.
Okay, here we go, guys. One more lap.
Grip is probably dropping due to wear, so don't be too aggressive.
P4 is ours.
Front is 12.6 seconds. This is your final lap of the race.
One more lap, guys, and it's P4. Okay guys, it's an excellent P4.
That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
So as they climb out of the car, the Red Bull team are ready and waiting to celebrate a thoroughly well-deserved win. Ant, talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
It was a question of right place, right time today. We were looking at an entirely different race before the safety car came out, but they were able to take full
Verstappen wins.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. So let's review the updated driver standings. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Carlos Sainz would be my first choice for this race. He had excellent race stamina, giving him the opportunity to charge through the ranks. Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice. I know that's at odds with the official decision, but I think they deserve some recognition on a day where both of these drivers are at the top of their game.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Okay, guys, there I am in P4. My teammate was down in P16, so unless we get some major improvement from him over the next few Grand Prix, I think I'm going to be looking for another teammate. I'll try and get him a better car, see if he improves any. Let's have a look at the standings. I'm in 9th with 14 points. And the Constructors were up to 7th with 14 points. So I think you'll agree, guys, in my first season, this isn't going too badly at all.
So that was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours. gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you?
I'm going to say the car is nimble and light. It was a breeze.
Your team must be ecstatic with how you're performing.
Maybe, but you can't get complacent.
Appreciate your time.
Thank you very much. Okay folks, I think you'll agree that was an excellent P4 in my first season. Anyway guys, I'm going to wrap things up for this episode. But I'll be back for another episode of F1 2020 My Team real soon. Once again guys, if you're enjoying the series and you liked the video, drop a thumbs up and a like down below. And don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, guys, I'll catch you later.